Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of Pine Hill Zoo. As you might read, today we are working on Peafowl Gardens, located just behind the main entrance of the zoo. Before I start talking about anything else, I need to tell you why I decided on doing an actual voiceover. So, the reason behind that is that I'm a very chaotic builder, as you might see, and if I could, I probably would do multiple things at once. So, as today's material has very many cuts, and I want you to look at those gardens as I do, here I am in the front of my microphone speaking to you and explaining everything piece by piece. But enough talking about that, let's focus on what's actually happening on the screen. As you might see, I'm doing here a planter in a very funky shape with custom benches and all of that. So the inspiration for this one came from Pinterest, as many of my inspiration came from there. When I saw a resting place, I saw that on Pinterest, with planters incorporated into benches, and from that moment I really badly wanted to incorporate into that one into my zoo. So that's the thing why I decided on making this planter. And now, as you can see, I'm placing some mulch in the planter, so our plants have a place to grow, basically. And you might see in a while that I have a very not so obvious plants choice. So it's all dictated by the forest that is surrounding the pine hill. And the whole idea about this planter is to resemble that forest, the fauna that is growing there. So those planters on the sides, as the one I'm building right now, will symbolize the forest that, as I said, is surrounding Pine Hill and doing all the good stuff like making oxygen and all of that. And yeah, that's the whole point of these planters being here. And as you might see, I use some bracken, some cowberry, crowberry, bearberry, all of those bushes, and a lot of those white flowers. They are called dwarf something. Please let me know in the comments if you know the name, because I'm a Pole, so yeah, that might be the case why I don't know many of the names, because I used to play on the Polish version of the Planet Zoo. But as I'm now doing some YouTube stuff, I think that I need to play on English mode, so you can see all of that. And as you might see, we are in the other frame right now, on the other scene. And on the left, you might have some peaks on the other forest planter that was built off-screen, as many of the things in today's build, because there was so much cutting and builds that were repetitive just were done behind the screen. So yeah, those planters will have an additional like layer between the benches, and there will be put some nettles and those dwarf something flowers to make it more interesting for guests. And now I'm doing a little border for the next planter that is coming to the zoo, and this one will be our first modern planter, the first planter in the collection of modern planters in Peafowl Gardens, because as on the sides there are forest planters symbolizing the wildlife and the nature side of the Pine Hill. Inside the gardens there will be some modern sculptures that show that Pine Hill is some sort of more modern looking zoo. That uses a lot from the nature, of course, as you might see in the fauna used in this planter and the other one that is coming in a few minutes. But yeah, I didn't tell you what is this, like what this planter is resembling. This planter will be the hill planter, because if you go to Pine Hill and you look at the map, you see that you can take a path to the left, and the path to the left gives you a nice stroll on the hill, so you see the animals that can live in the hilly environment, on the steep hills and everything like that. And you can see that you have a path to the right, and the path to the right is the path that leads you to the river section of the zoo. and there will be some animals that require more flat areas, and more aquatic animals will be there, as seal show that I plan for future episodes. When it comes to flat terrain animals, I think that the best example is African elephant, of course, which I'm planning on adding into this zoo, and a giraffe, because when you think about those animals, you think about natural barriers that block them from going to certain places, as for example in Warsaw Zoo. It's a little fun fact, you have the only barrier that makes giraffes stay in their enclosure and don't hurt guests and all of that is a little mound that I think is 1 meter on 1.5 meter deep, and that's the only barrier that makes giraffe stay inside and like enjoy their lives when they are kept and fed by zookeepers to have their pretty nice lives. And as you can see, sorry for talking about Warsaw Zoo, but I really like that one. The whole planter will have 3 layers, so there is nothing specific behind it, it's just 3 layers because I wanted 3 layers. And all of the layers will have some plants growing on them, some fauna. And the plant selection, as you might see in a moment, is pretty much they are pretty much the plants that I used in the forest, as I call them planters. To outline the borders of each part of the planter, I use they are called, oh man, that's a hard thing. I think they are called berberry bushes, because there are in the game we have crowberry, berberry, and cowberry bushes, and I think those are berberry I used for the outlining planters. And you can see I'm now planting some crowberry bushes to resemble the grass, but in the end I didn't like this combination, so I changed the crowberry to cowberry, which is more sort of yellowish. So the cypress trees that are used here to resemble the trees that grow on the hill itself contrast a little bit more with the grass part of the enclosure, of course. And now I'm doing the lowest part of the whole planter, so as I call it, the ground level, and I'm using the same combination of plants. Berberry, yeah, that one I use for outlining the whole thing, and cowberry I will use to make sure that it isn't so bare, that there is some texture to the whole thing, and because it looks really nice with that cowberry on the floor, and some more cypress trees to resemble, as I said, little trees that grow on the hill, and if you can, and you can experience them in their miniature in their miniature face in here, or you can go take a stroll on the hill and see them in their full glory. So now, as I said, I'm placing some cowberry bushes, and next up some cypress trees, and we're, I think, good to go. In the meantime, I did some fence putting, as you might see in the on the video, that there is some fence put into the ground, as the one in the entrance, in the main alley, on that 2 planters. And I'm using the same rocks here to make it look more modern, more detailed. And I must say that those little rocks are possibly my favorite piece in the entire game, because they are so nice and so universal. You can use them in every enclosure, you can use them in mud baths, you can use them near the forks to give some more texture. The only thing, and they of course come from South American temple set, and the only thing I must say that really bothers me is that they are the only thing that is used and that came with the South American temple pieces theme that is not flexicolor. So that's a shame, and the worst thing is that you are making, I don't know, a reddish sort of or black temple, and then you need, then you want to make some parts of the temple that had that fallen out, that fell out. Oh, yeah, they fell out, and you need to use those gray, not flexi color things, so that will look pretty stupid for me, but yeah, we can't do anything like that. Maybe Frontier has some bigger plans behind it. And now, as you can see, we are in the next planter, as the previous one is pretty much done. We are now doing the river planter. As I said, there are two integral parts of the Pine Hill, so the hill part, and then there is the river part. And I can say that I don't know which one will be my favorite. I have great plans for both of them, so I'm really looking forward to how it will look in the end, the whole zoo. And maybe you can decide what is your favorite part in the comments when we do like the final tour of the zoo. So nothing spectacular here, it will be pretty much the same as the hill planter. And as you can see, I dug out that hole off screen because I, in the first place, I wanted the water to be above the ground level, and I wanted to use some glass barriers to make it work. But in the end, when I placed the water into the glass barriers and I wanted to lower the glass, it basically didn't work. So yeah, that was a shame. So I decided to like give a try to an underground water thingy, and here I am building it, and this is my final decision. And as you can see, there is the same choice of fauna in this one, so the two planters look basically the same, and that's what I wanted, because as they are two integral parts of the Pine Hill, they need to look at least similar in some ways to resemble the hole, as the Pine Hill is a hole. And yeah, that's it. Some more cowberry for the grass. I still need to teach myself that name, I need to learn them. Some berberries for the outlining the habitat, and some cypress trees to make it all shine and make it like a little miniature of the river itself. In the meantime, I did some rugs and fence thingies, as you can see on the sides, as in the first planter. And now I'm doing some details to make this whole area live, like make it more lively and lifelike. So I'm putting some water effects to resemble that this is the place where the water came out after it being in serious circulation. And here I'm putting some bubbles to resemble the place where the water is, comes in. And now there was a little experiment. I saw a few months ago the lady designer using those foam pieces to make the her river in her African zoo shine and make it more lifelike. And it looked good, don't get me wrong, but it didn't work for me, at least with a thing that isn't an actual river but something that man made. So I deleted it in the end. And as our video is speeding forward and lots of things were cut, we are now in the ivy frame section. So this will be the alley where you can go below the some sort of modernistic frames with ivy on it. And as you might recognize the shape, it's obviously from the main alley, it's inspired by that. So I'm inspired by myself, so that's a pretty unique thing for me. And I don't know what else to say about them. Oh, maybe I can say that they are the first thing I did with ivy, so this was my first ivy encounter in the game. And as I have 500 hours spent in Planet Zoo, I never used ivy, and that was really really weird for me, but who cares? I think no one will ever say, yeah, you are a Planet Zoo builder and you didn't use ivy in first 100 hours of your game. So yeah, This one, as you can see, I'm experimenting with Australia Pack metal rods, but in the end I didn't like them, so I used some fence pieces to make those frames on which ivy can grow and like make those really nice tunnels and I don't know, ivy corridors. And I predict that, yeah, there will be a jump in time. In the meantime, I did some wooden planks to fill the shape of the frame, and I put some ivy, and believe me or not, it was a serious pain putting all the ivies on the frames and making it not look so repetitive, so every frame has every of these three frames has its own ivy, its own ivy structural thing, so its own ivy placement, okay, that's the word I was looking for. And now we did some planters below the ivy frames, so the ivy has some dirt to grow on and like have a happy life. And as you can see, now I'm using some Q-paths to make 3-meter paths, because it's not possible with the normal paths we have in the game, to make some sort of a hidden garden behind those frames. And yeah, this garden will be one of my favorites, I believe, in the whole gardens. And I'm using the same choice of plants as I did in the modern planters done before. So the hill and the river ones, Burberry, I know that one, now I know, Burberry used for outlining the whole thing, and cowberry, no, there is no cowberry in this one, because I wanted to stay with the ground we currently have, so the grass, the actual in-game grass. And the idea behind this this thing was to make it feel modern, and when I think about modern gardens and modern style, I'm thinking about shapes, geometrical shapes, mostly of cubes. So I wanted to use some cubes to make it look, I think, nice. And this garden is full of those cubes filled with those dwarf something flowers. And yeah, that's the that's basically it for this garden. There will be some cypress trees coming in few seconds to make it more lifelike. And yeah, one thing I must say, that I recently found those anchor pieces and I use them a lot now, so all of those cubes are made out of them, the whole borders for the pavement is made of them, the fountain that will come in few minutes is made out of them pretty entirely. So yeah, I do love those pieces, and they have so nice texture to them, and they are pretty small, so they work basically for everything. And as you can see, I'm doing some rocks to make it more lifelike, this little garden, hidden garden. And now back to the whole garden thing. So I found out that the lamppost have some grass peeking through below them, so I wanted to cover it up, and I used those circles from Art Shapes, Art Shape category. And yeah, I thought, like, if I need to do that one with one of the lampposts, I need to do it with all the lampposts. And as I don't like it that much, before it was better without those circles, but without the circles there was grass, of course, there. And yeah, I needed to sacrifice something. And now I'm placing some benches to make benches and tables, of course, to make this whole umbrella passage really nice. And I did them off screen, and they are based on the benches I used for forest planters, of course. And now the last part of our today's Pifol Garden episode. So this is the moment when we are doing an actual fountain, very nice fountain for me. And the idea behind it was to make a peacock fountain. And you might shout on me right now, no, you should call it Pifol because it's the species name. Yes, I know, but this fountain was here to resemble the male Pifol, so the peacock. Now you know why I called it like that. And yeah, I think in the end it doesn't work like I wanted it to work. It doesn't look like pickaxe, so now it's just a fountain made by an artist, some sort of artist. And I think it would be other artists that ones that did the hill and the river planters and the cube gardens and the ivy frames, because this one uses more of like New World color scheme. So you have black combined with light brown planks, and it looks really modern for me. Off screen, I did the whole shape of it. It's more straight in shapes, not many curves in here, and planters will be very simple, featuring some cypress trees and of course those dwarf thingies. And yeah, I think that's basically it, and I'm going to goodbye you guys for now, because it's going to be the last part of the video. And I must thank you for being here with me, and if everything goes in the right way, we should meet each other in the second episode of Pitfall Gardens, because this building is incomplete, as you can see, because there are no pitfalls. It's because of that that Pitfall Gardens will be connected to a pretty other building that will come in the future episodes, but no spoilers for now. Thank you for watching, and I think speak to you guys in the next episode. Goodbye!